Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We are on the morning commute, the day of this video going live. And that's because I was gonna film this video yesterday on my commute, and I forgot my camera at home. Today, we're gonna talk about five things that I take for granted about my S4. Now, this video idea kind of came around from me driving my mother's car for 2 weeks. Now, my mother has a Honda Pilot. She was away on a trip, so I drove that car to work for 2 weeks and realized that there are a couple things about this car and about German cars in general that I take for granted. Isn't that a fun noise? My brakes are really squeaky when it's cold outside in the morning. They don't have any heat in them because I just got on the highway. So, apologies in advance if you hear that noise. It's just my brakes. The first thing that I really take for granted about this car is just the pure quickness of the car. It's so easy if there's a gap in traffic or whatever, you just put your foot in it just a little bit and it only downshifts maybe one gear, just bop, over. Same thing if someone's driving slow, stuff like that. It's just so easy to get around and zip in and out of traffic in this car. And then, you know, when you finally do get free from traffic and grandma and her Camry is right there, it's nice for her not to be able to pull on you. It also makes me feel a lot safer when merging on the highway to be in a car that's quick. Because you know, if there's a car coming up and you're not quite sure if you're gonna get in front of it, instead of having to slow down or stop on the on-ramp, you just give it a little extra and you get out in front of that car. Obviously, I'm not doing that dangerously. I'm not, you know, zipping around like this, but when there's a car coming in the first lane and you're merging on the highway like this, it's nice to be able to get in front of them and get on the highway instead of slowing down and, you know, maybe causing more danger. The second thing I take for granted about this car and most German cars is the fact that when you flick the blinker or the indicator, if you're not from Boston, the indicator flashes 3 times. So all I have to do is turn it up and it goes flash, flash, flash towards that direction or that direction, obviously. If you own a German car, you know what I'm talking about. My mother's car does not do that, so I often found myself signaling to change lanes and just tapping the indicator, and that would turn the blinker on once. And then I would move over a lane and look like a total jerk, so I'd have to hold the blinker up and then turn it off. That's obviously a little thing, but you know, when you're changing lanes a lot, especially when you're in traffic and commuting 30 something miles a day, really annoying that every time you have to change lanes, you have to hold the blinker on. I'd like to just tap it and have it go. The third thing I take for granted about this car is these heated seats. Now, I know I always said that heated seats weren't necessary until I finally got a car with them. What's nice about them, and I'm sure those with heated seats can relate, is in the morning, when the car is cold, you don't have to turn the heat on and you don't have to wait for the heat to turn on for the car to get warm. You just turn your heated seat up all the way, and because that's electric instead of powered through the car's climate control, it warms up pretty much instantaneously, especially these Audi seats on 3. They like to toast your bum. The fourth thing I take for granted about this car is just how planted it is. When traffic opens up, and especially later on in my commute, there's a 65 mile an hour section where people are routinely doing about 80 miles an hour because I assume everybody is late to work. This car feels so planted. It stays in its lane. I mean, I could probably take my hands off the wheel at like 80 or 90 miles an hour and the car would just go straight. Obviously, I'm not gonna do that, but it's so easy to drive and just keep in the lane. It's also at high speeds, not wobbly. With the Pilot, if you went like this at a high speed, it kind of gives you a little wiggle in the hips, if you know what I'm saying. Whereas this car is very smooth, stays planted. It's nice to be confident in the car where, you know, if something were to jump out in front of you or if someone were to swerve into you, a sudden movement like to change lanes or to go around said object isn't gonna upset the car and or flip you over. So, I mean, that's a little thing that's kind of common sense until you drive a big SUV and then you're like, wow, yeah, that I do take that for granted, the fact that I can just swerve and switch lanes and do whatever, and I'm not gonna worry about the car kind of wobbling. Now, the final thing that I take for granted about this car is just how wonderful these brakes are. This car, it's almost guaranteed that for most cars on the road, you will be stopping before they will. Now, it's not like this car has huge brakes, yet they're sporty brakes, the car is set up well, and if someone were to slam on their brakes in front of me, aside from hitting the car in front of them, I'm fairly confident I could stop before them as long as my, you know, my reaction was on. The only times that you're really gonna question whether or not you can stop in time is times of user error, basically. If I'm not paying attention to traffic, obviously this car's not gonna save me like a Tesla would. It's just a good car. This is a good car, and I take that for granted. So for all of you saying that I don't appreciate my car, there's like 3 people who have commented that, not all of you. I really, really like this car, and I really do appreciate it. And you can tell I appreciate it because we're almost at 70,000 miles, even though I bought it in June with 56,000. Anyway, yeah, keep an eye out for Sunday's video. That may or may not be a big brake install. Let me know some things about this car that you really like, or some things about your car that you take for granted. Thank you guys for watching. Go out there and spread some positivity, and I will catch you guys in the next video.